Hello and welcome to video 18 of the Artisy Draft First Steps tutorial series. In the previous video, we learned how we can use the conflict search to find issues within our project. With this video, we have arrived at the end of the First Steps series. We will take another look at the presentation mode to see how we can edit variable values to simulate specific situations. Then we will conclude with some advice on how you can continue your Artisy Draft journey. We use variables in our project to store various game states. If we want to simulate only parts of the project, or maybe include things for which values have not been set yet, we have the option to edit the initial variable values for the presentation. Go to the Final Confrontation Dialog node in the tutorial folder and submerge into it. You remember that at the very beginning, we have a reaction point in which we check for the name revealed variable. A change to the variable value can only happen in the first dialog. So if we just do a simulation of the second dialog, naturally this variable will always have its default starting value. Another thing we might want to test in this final confrontation dialog is the option at the choice point that is only available if the player has the stake item with them. Currently, there is no way implemented in the project to get the item, so this option would never be a valid one for the player to choose in the simulation. How can we change that? Start a simulation from the first dialog fragment. Now click on the Journey entry in the Navigator or the Setting button in the toolbar. Go to the Initial Variable Values tab. Here we see a list of all variables. I will change the values for the name revealed and the stake variables to true. It is important to know that changing values here only affects the current simulation. You do not change the variable values permanently. Now we can go back to the simulation by clicking the Play icon in the toolbar. If we go through the simulation in player mode, we will see that thanks to our value change, the reaction point follows the branch with Dracula knowing and using Mina's name. When we arrive at the choice point, the option tied to the item is available now too. Being able to edit variable values allows for widely varied testing scenarios when running simulations of your project. If you are looking for any kind of information regarding Artisy Draft, the support page on artisy.com should be your starting point. Downloads, FAQ, and means to contact the support team, everything can be found here. If you want to review any information or dive deeper into a topic, visit the Help Center for an extensive documentation. You can find the link to the support page and all other resources mentioned in this lesson in the video description. Now that you have taken our first steps in Artisy and are able to find your way around the software, you might want to take a look at our more advanced demo projects. If you installed the entire package back when starting this series, you can open the other projects right from the project list. If not, you can download them from artisy.com. If you are a Unity or Unreal user, the Maniac Manfred project might be worth a closer look. In addition to the Maniac Manfred demo project, you can also download the corresponding engine projects to see in detail how Artisy data gets integrated. If you are interested to see a selection of games made with Artisy, visit our showcase page on artisy.com. Our customers range from indie to big studios, who use Artisy Draft for a wide variety of games, spanning all platforms. For interviews with interesting people in and around the game industry, visit our YouTube channel. To stay informed in all topics related to Artisy, for news about the games industry, or to get in touch with us, follow our social media channels on Facebook and Twitter. We love to hear from our users. You have done your first steps. Now it is time for the next part of your journey with your very own project. All the best, and see you around.